just newspaper, old notes, junk mail, more notes, and then fabric scraps that I had from using for other different stuff. Mostly newspaper, which I wish there was more white paper in it, but the newspaper is easier to tear up. I will use this paper, put it in a blender with water. Okay, so that's like a good consistency. And make sure not to puree it really, so it still has some chunks left in it. And sometimes that looks pretty cool in the paper when it's done. So now it'll separate if you just let it settle. So that's kind of how you stir it up. There's not very much water in the bottom of this, or like liquid for me to dip my screen into, so I'm gonna add more water, I think. Pull it up. You can do it again just to get it covered more. And the shaking part isn't really important, but it does help a little bit to even it out. Flip it over. And it has like so much water in it. You see all that water.
If I didn't have these boxes, I don't know what I would use. Just saying.
I think that it was great. Size. Yeah. Everything about it is perfect.
It's a learning process. Trial and error. I really like using different things that I had, because otherwise I would have just thrown them away. It's cool that I can make something out of them that is useful. It's kind of like a craft, but I like it. I would kind of like to do more things like this, like repurpose things. That might be the part where we get stuck. Done it with the felt before. So let me take the other one. This is all what I learned from that DVD that you gave me, and I also like used an online reference just to see what else is out there.
Great.
But that's basically it. Like, then you just have to let it dry.
I think it's pretty.
I do too. I like the flex.
Me too.
So I think that it doesn't stick to the felt, you know?
I think it's going to be really good paper.